And the issue is that if the subvention is coming steady and staff are paid as well, I believe those of them who will go into sorting are doing that out of greed. So I'm appealing to you, sir. The council, we are ready to partner with you people to move this university to the height you are aspiring for. But the basic things must be done before we go back to the promised land. Thank you, sir. Anybody who doesn't behave the way that is expected of him to be ready to face such committees and their structures, I believe. So coming to IGR, necessarily, IGR may not be only two students that we may generate IGR. If the university thinks of business approach to our IGR, I don't see why we cannot generate IGR. For instance, we have filling station. Most of the university from having a filling station here and farms like Adishieke and ensure that our staff buys from such a filling station. Yes. Before now, there used to be buildings here where we were running shape. Now late, he had some pumps. He was using it for pumps. So we have the land. Nothing equally stops the university, even if it means asking people to build it on agreement so that they, when they receive their money, the university will have the hostels. What stops us from having some hostels here? So, and some other places, so that when rents are generated, we can have some money. Thank you, sir.
The chairman of the council and members of the lovely council of the Voices University, the university management head by the Vice Chancellor, our dear colleagues and friends, the lecturers. Sir, the question you raised on the issue of university autonomy is a welcome idea. However, there are so many sacrifices and approaches and needs planning before it's attained. It's attainable, but it needs planning. On the moral aspect of it, integrity and character, nobody is worrying about that. It's what should be and what it should be. Because for somebody to be dating his own daughter or so on and so forth is out of it. Or giving astrologers is out of it. What I want to emphasize is we will cooperate personally with the council on the issues raised. I'm appealing that the academic staff and non-academic staff who are working very, very hard and have high level of integrity should also be motivated, appreciated. Yeah, you've done well. You have denied yourself this, denied yourself that, despite the fact that you're supposed to have done this. This is the reward for it. Then it will encourage other people not to, to behave the same way. Then, of course, as you said, sir, anybody who commits crime, the law should be applied to the person. It's not because one is from A or from B. That's also a welcome idea. That will keep us to be very, very conscious of our behavior, that if we do it, no matter the person you are, it will not go that way. Sir, another thing is, yes, sir, we need expansion of programs. We need to accredit our departments. We need to develop infrastructure in the university. And all these are capital intensive projects. With the lean income from the state government, the council can think outside box, as we should also think outside box in order to generate money. The council should think outside box in order to attract funds outside what we are generating in the university. Thank you, therefore. There are so many places, so many opportunities, investment opportunities, where to make money. But the easiest way of making money in the university is expansion of programs, school fees, and then foreign fund investment. That's the issue. Because it takes some money in order to build the police station, it takes some gestation period in order to start reaping dividends from the police station industries and so on and so forth. Sir, the director of consultancy will give you, because we submitted to the management, very, very detailed write-up from this wonderful academic staff we have here of their intention, what should be done in order to make more money from university. Some of them are what can be done immediately. What does need planning? Because need money in order to invest, in order to make profit. Without investment, you don't see it, money will not come. But the other things we can do in order to have an immediate income for the university. Again, sir, we thank God, and thank God for the governor of the Abuja State for cassetting us. However, sir, there are so many of our elders, the founding fathers of this university. 10 years they have retired. Some of them are not coming out because they cannot even keep up certain things. I'm pleading, sir, whether it will be possible to fine-tune that cassetting in order for these people and people who will retire immediately to start enjoying their pension. Even if the gratuity is not to be paid immediately, but every month, these wonderful men and women who have sacrificed to get us where we are should be able to say, university actually gave me my pension today, this month. And next month, I have the opportunity to get another one. Finally, sir, our students need to be accommodated in the university campus. That is one of the ways we can be in charge of their character. Because when we preach to them at the age of 18, 20, 24, that you should do this, to do that, they've formulated their character. And when they go back to their cubicles, the thing is evaporating. And then we go back to what other people are doing in the ghetto they are dwelling. So if we have the university students in the campus, then the university will pass through them, and then we pass through the university, and then we will have the result. We will join you, sir, in order to get to that promised land where Ebonyi people, our integrity will be manifested across the world, not only in Nigeria, but across the world. Thank you, and God bless you. God bless you.
Okay, I think I will respond to this very before I forget it. The first one was on the issue of creating the environment for things to generate a revenue for academic program. I think, as I said, this is a new council. This is the vision of the Council of Africa. And we don't begin it. We know what you say, and we'll be working towards that. When other, for the past few meetings and weeks, what we're trying just to put together where we are in this university as of now, particularly financially. Once that is done, the next thing is planning. Where do we go from here? Think it through what you mentioned. Let me reveal to you that the council has been thinking. If you've been to Ibadan, or if you've been to the third generation universities, the accommodation for staff and students makes a lot of difference, just like you said, in the character and the academic performance. I'm always impressed when I go to that and see the staff, the way they live and what they do in the educational areas. This is what this council intends to create on the permanent side. Staffing, staff working. Staff quarters must before this council you must be available to stand. Another area is hostel for students. It's not just hostel. I want hostel for students and catering so that they don't cook to the veranda. So that they don't have to go to the veranda. I give them the opportunity to experience as students. You get up, you're studying, it's time for dinner, you go there and eat and go back to your study. Now you go and start with your hand writing. You know what you thought of for the soup. So this I show that's the area we are heading towards. And as I said, this is the beginning. We will get there and I will all expand the program so that that's the source of income. But to respond to the IGR, this is what I said earlier. He has this idea. Put it in writing and send to the council. And I solicit from everybody the same thing. There are things we remember. There are many things we looked at already within the university. And we're working on them for IGR generation. There are many, many possibilities. That in your department, in your faculty, there are issues that you can bring even to outside yours. Where you see other, like the guest houses, we've talked about what we're going to do in those areas. So IGR, as I said, is the business of all of us. We must think outside the box and make suggestions as to what will help us to do this. On the issue of motivation, yes, as I said, we'll have a very comfortable accommodation for you, and I think that's a good thing. On the issue of pension, you know this contributory pension is just being worked out. But those who have retired don't fall into that. And the issue we are looking at now is what the financial status for the university, before we know where we're going to spend money. But yes, those who have sacrificed for the university should be taken care of. Otherwise, others would not be able to. So, I think I've addressed the three issues that were raised. And we'll entertain a few more. But let me also, in the spirit of what we are talking, we will only excuse the way people are coming in because of the suddenness of this meeting. But otherwise, we schedule a meeting at 10 o'clock. It is discipline to be there at 10 o'clock. I just rolling in now and I'm almost finishing up when we are rolling in. So please let's begin with ourselves. And it's not the APC change begins with me. This is the academic attitude that you must have self-discipline in everything you do. So please let's take note that those who are meeting. Try and make arrangements. You are not informed on time to make this arrangement. So that's why we're excusing you. But if you have enough notice, make arrangement so that you'll be at a meeting. So we begin to hear from the beginning what is happening, not to come in the middle. So let's entertain a few more questions and then we can round up. Yes, who has the microphone?
Chairman and members of the council and colleagues, my name is John Ididi from the Department of Industrial Council. Chairman, the area I want to address is the issue of staff discipline. Why we generally condone indiscipline and misconduct among us, I want the council to please be fair in their dealings. Let there be proper investigation. If a staff is suspected, I think by constitution, the person is still acknowledged to be innocent but is proved guilty. The issue of putting somebody on suspension when an allegation has just been given against him without investigation is not too fair. It's after the investigation and he or she is found guilty or wanted, that appropriate punishment should be given. So I would want the council to be fair in handling this, to put proper investigation into prospect. Secondly, the way I want to draw is also our own dignity of labor. You have said it, the Abolo State University is not inferior to any university in the world. We have the same curriculum and standard. So the management and the council should help us to maintain this standard. It baffles most of us go to classrooms. You see ladies, small girls carrying pure water, carrying any granite. It's written while lectures are going on to say. And there are not as they are supposed to check some of all this. It distracts people bringing their children into lecture halls. I think this sort of things should be looked into. It demoralizes our image as a university. We are not the poorest and can never be the poorest. Then, secondly, or thirdly, sorry, thank you very much. The chairman addressed it. This issue of dichotomy is very much clear in this institution. I hope the council addressed it. It's very much biting and it's discouraging. Since I joined this university in 1998, about 19 years ago, I've never seen an advert for position in any discipline, any department. When people are being recruited, it's when these adverts are placed, people are applying. Criteria we use, like local government or so, in discipline. I've never seen an advert. It's almost regularly and busy. So, people should help it and address this irregularity and imbalance. And lastly, and fourthly, which centers also the list. So, also with our admission policy. So I hope that there are no more tasks that the council has to do. I know some people will be injured, but take the heart and do it. It will, those of us that came from Anambra or Enugu were complaining of marginalization. But what of the world we are doing to ourselves? The marginalization we are doing to ourselves. Who do we complain to? So, Thank you, sir.
Chairman of the Council and members of the Council, the Vice Chancellor, my name is Ike Elechi Oba, Director of Academic Planning, Professor of Marketing. I want to speak on two areas. One is the issue of cultism, and the other one is on cost. What I want to say on the terms of cultism is that there is no way a university will produce cultists unless there are people ready to buy the product called cultism and the students. We need to tell ourselves the truth. Some of the council members are politicians, and you people are the buyers of those products. We are going to tell ourselves the truth. This is our university. This is our land. When we in the university don't have enough infrastructures and resources to train these children and bring them to the level they should be, they get frustrated. Then automatically they groom themselves by the funding of politicians to become criminals who carry guns and matches and knives. And who do they kill? They kill politicians and the children of politicians and also cause mayhem and problem within the university. Who do we blame? University management. I am suggesting that the council chairman remains a partner of the state and a former deputy governor. So he ranks as number two in this state. We have ambassadors, we have senators. Please, our statement is, and ministers, please go back to your constituency
And let the governor also help and train our politicians and get them to stop buying quality students. That's number one. Number two, we're an IGR. We can generate as many revenue, or if we decide to call it profit, which doesn't apply, we can generate billions upon billions of money and we waste them if we don't first of all begin to cut costs. We must cut costs first, so that we then know areas that our money is being wasted, then we can sit back to talk about IGR. IGR should run 40%, while cut costing should run 60%. After 3 or 4 years, that's the procedure in management planning. You can then introduce expanded revenue generation. First, to end to that, what I'm saying is, there are essential actions that we must take. Within the university, we've cut down imprints. Ask any HOD or any dean whether the imprints they receive worth anything as it used to be before. No, it doesn't. And if I'm lying, they are here. The imprints is almost very, very low compared with some other universities. That's a good step. I'm also saying that with time, within this austerity, we can even go further to cut costs. That's fine. But in America, the president of America said, don't think of what America will do for you. Think of what you will do for America. If council is willing to partner with us and see us as colleagues, colleagues and friends and family pushing to achieve a common goal, one of the things we must do is to reduce the level of the presence of authority and superiority. We feel somehow that the council is up there on top of Europe, and we are below. And therefore, with such gap, it will make every staff, I'm now speaking from a behavioral psychologist point of view, every staff will not only be demotivated, but will lack basic commitment. And will become an armchair manager, sit down they look. If you say come, yes, I will come. If you say go, yes, I will go. At the end of the day, nothing will be achieved. And for your information, salary will be paid. And at the end of the day, we're wasting our time. So the gap between council and members must be shrunk. The final thing for me to suggest is, council must also show evidence of commitment, put action to words. If we've reduced our interest, which we also will be willing to reduce more, council should either scrap up their sitting allowance or thank you very much.
Thank you very much. This is the time to harvest and harness this investment. So,
colleagues,
I think you are very, very lucky. Mr. Chairman,
I want to start by urging us.
Mr. Chairman.
Okay, Mr. Chairman,
I'm humbly referred and named Francis Uche Ogu. By the grace of God, the brand new chairman of ASU. Thank you very much. I think I stand on better, on a better pedestal now. Mr. Chairman, I want to fire. Provoking lecture this morning. Very interesting, Mr. Chairman. Especially on the issue of moral decadence. This is where the problem lies. The society is the problem, not the other way. First, a wonderful community. We can have a society where the result of primary school children are reaped by teachers. Because parents are there asking them to give them grades at primary school level. This child moves to the next level of secondary school. Go around and find the quality of secondary school book is around. Quality of best of life. These parents insist that this child was studying law, medicine, and so on and so forth. And the next point of call is about taking it. That's where the problem is. Our leads will start flying for admission. For government house, for house housing, for local governments, even council members. So when we do so, the child must graduate. Parents insist that the child must. And that's where it starts. Mr. Chairman, it will surprise you to go to the other analysis. And look at the various hostels surrounding the analysis. Our parents these days must wake up. Their sons and daughters are living in one room in the name of couple. Our daughters are collaborating with boys, their schoolmates, campus couple, they call it. They decorate themselves as husband and wife. In the campus, in those places, David, you cannot imagine when is the time to go through their course contents. When is the time to go for their lecture? Marriage is a very serious business. So why would you stop a married couple to attend lecture by 8 o'clock? What is Mr. Chairman? I'm going to use the vice aspect to say examination. Now, the students must pass. That's what it says. Most of the requests for sorting and housing are not there, Mr. Chairman. I have served as Associate Dean of Student Affairs of this university for the past 9 years, unbroken 9 years. I know what the students do. These people do not know how to wear trousers from their family, Mr. Chairman. We go around adjusting their trousers from campus to campus. To know their family, Mr. Chairman. They call it sacking. It is so strange to the guests. To the extent that Mr. Francisco embarks on what we call a leap the proton from campus to campus. When I was in university, it was very rare to see a person. We devote a week to talk to a student. Now we're doing that. Society is the problem. We have tried to maintain our integrity this year. We have a procedure for getting those that are not doing well. We have the rule of discipline. We are so angry, we always angry, any staff caught in any act. is diminished, Mr. Chairman.
But I want to tell you, Mr. Chairman, that
his claim, the claim that they are saying, will have become so demoralized in our workplaces. The truth is that the motivation is going down. We are so weak to deliver. We are so weak to work. That's the truth. Our productivity has gone down to a level that something must happen. What will you say of a university who at inception, was ranking 10 best universities in the world, state universities in the world? 10 best state universities in the world. We are 27th in the committee of universities in this country. 27th. What is our rank now? We are so demoralized in this country. There is mass exodus of lecturers. These people you see are patriotic. Very, very patriotic. The law for this state. We have the qualities to live. If you go to our cities, you realize that they are people. They have up calls every day from private universities, from state universities, from other state universities that under their accreditation. You ask yourself, have we faltered in accreditation? No! Nobody's getting it right. But there are other factors that are not available. That is why we are where we are now. We need to kickstart again. We need to take off again. What do you say of a university that has 11 faculties in the recent past? Now shrunk to 8 faculties. Is that expansion? What are we? Are we the factor of integration or for integration? We need to demand faculties for extraction purposes. If you don't expand the university, you don't get revenue. We are here to bring highly professional programs to the university. We have faculty of engineering, faculty of environmental sciences, these things. The best schools faculties. I don't think we have the best of environment. It's not because of environmental science is dead, this is not. We don't have pharmacy as faculty. We don't have dentistry. We don't have veterinary medicine. So we still need to add about 5 faculties in addition to the merging of our faculties. Mr. Chairman, sir, on revenue, I beg to differ, Mr. Chairman. It is difficult to introduce elements of capitalism in the university system, even at Harvard. Capitalism and the university system do not work together. Tango is not abroad. First, I own the NGOs and corporate organizations. So when you say this is a public university and you introduce capitalism in the university, how do they go together? Unless you say, there are two common sectors. You have the social sector, you have the economic sector. Even in state budget preparation, you have the social sector, you have the economic section. There are ministries and departments of government that use revenue. There are ministries and departments of government that are serviced. So also the university. What will archaeology and sociology produce? What will the English produce? The religion, are they ever miss us here? Unless churches. So we can harness the economic programs to generate revenue. There's nothing you can do about the social programs.
So we cannot be chasing about staff, lecturers, to generate revenue. It's strange. It's very, very strange. It's capitalism. Mr. Chambers, there are other issues and other issues. But we cannot avail ourselves and take off. Mr. Chambers, I talked about great revenue. I'm also worried about the new generation. We have always climbed down from our height. If we behave like academics, we know what it means to behave like an academic. We have a way we have to behave like academics. But we don't do so. If I go to my CV and put on my suit as an academic, I say this I don't do. So also, I would say, and sisters. But we know that some tasks will come so low to ask the students to pay their school fees. Yes. It's not our duty as academics. We have the very department of the university, which is the bursary unit. So you talk to the bursary about revenue generation. You can review the data on leakages. There is what they call internal audit in the bursary. So bursary is revenue generation and also it is self-regulated by the place of internal audit. I will go on and go, Mr. Chairman, but I will not stop at this opportunity to tell you that this demoralization can be removed today once we get our Kondoas Arians. Their new salary structure. We battled the politicians, broke their hands because of 2011 election and succeeded in Kondoas Arias. It ran into several months of arrears. Up till now, 11 is outstanding. Now, what is the value of this money now? Was there, the exchange rate was 150 naira per dollar. Now it is 500 naira per dollar. So even if you give us the good ones, it's not okay. So if it is not in the budget of 2017, please quickly, quickly adjust the budget and include Kondoas in the budget. Now and now. We cannot have slow allocation for Kondoas Arians. Mr. Chambers, every now and then, I cannot quote my salary comfortably. I cannot quote, nobody here can quote his salary. You cannot quote their salary. Every month you get disparity of salary. Rank to rank, rank by rank, Mr. Chairman. Because of unwarranted introduction of tax system that is unknown to Nigeria as a federation. There are laws of taxation, clear laws of taxation. I include the amendments. I'm going by Mr. Wolf is there. There is BIT Act of 2011. When you have a concurrent legislation, various components, federating units are encouraged to copy home. In our own case, somebody somewhere saw BIT Act 26.7%. Without knowing the ingredients of that, and attack my salary. for you to do that, you must subtract 8% pension, subtract 5% NHIS, subtract 2.5% housing, subtract 1% insurance. The appropriate tax for us, the university and the other university in this country, is 11.2%. But I tell you, what they move from our salaries are 20.16% every month. Mr. Chairman, the issue is the last. We are so demoralized. Imagine 20.1% of 100,000 naira. What's the balance? What's the balance? Why do you, these people who trade right from primary to secondary, we said they are not to start, now they are investing. Instead of increasing, they are decreasing. We are really, really in trouble, Mr. Chairman. I don't know where to end. Is it possible? I'm 44 now. I'll be 45 in August. Is it possible in 2018 by God's grace for me to be 30 years? Is it possible? I think I should be happy with age. Now, the professor, my salary is senior lecturer. Who is cheating? There's no motivation. The joy of an academic is that you attain a level. Every service you render, our job, we do it in the car, we do it in the office. You ask them, phone call. Even as we are here, we are doing our job. A program that runs from undergraduate to postgraduate. We have so many people, I supervise more than 18 PhD students. My own self. You can imagine Professor Ebu Yeko. Is he here? You can imagine what you have. Our workload. The professor and the standard of his candidate is painful. It's absolutely painful. So it's unacceptable to us. We reject it in Jesus' name. Yeah. The issue of practice is that there is a year of appraisal. You are praised, you are qualified. When you get a letter, it will read with effect from WDF. And when you are paid, the next thing is that even without request, you get a large on the address of a promotion. Why has it stopped? If we rise, I think the entire state will shake. But we don't want to rise now. We want to give you the benefit of all the doubts. We will still visit you, Mr. Chairman. Every university in this country has paid every academic allowance. Except the president. What we have seen, we have produced one of the best graduates in this country. Go and check the record. Anybody thinking about the president university should be careful because our records are clear. From the graduates to PhD, we have data for students overseas of what they are doing there. There are decisions here. Despite the environment, despite the quality of facilities, we stand shoulder high because of our quality. Why is it that all the excess load they carry are not paid? We are so demoralized, Mr. Chairman. I just want to thank you and sit down.
I think I can characterize this as a response to your new chairman. That's a response to your new chairman. And I'm sure from the beginning, he's relieved. As Sidi is relieved, and Razoma has taken over this duty. And so we thank you very much for your contribution. And I'm sure you're happy your comrade, but I'm a senior comrade. The first thing you have to behave before me. I think you actually chairman. I congratulate you on your winning election yesterday. We hope that I'm happy you are here to hear the council and that we know that we are after one thing, the good of this university. And we do not want anybody who has interest to do anything to the level. I think I will start by responding to your comments, then I'll go to the other. You raised the issue, again, something I will emphasize very much about what happens with primary school, the secondary school, the sorting and all that. I think it is wrong for anybody, and I hear people do it. Personally, I don't do it, and my children are spanked when they do it. You don't use an example of somebody doing something wrong to do something wrong. It's bad. If they sort in it, primary school, and it sends you a wrong person, an unqualified person, it is for you in your own character to change that person. Do your best. You don't start saying well, because when the children become in there, you must cheat to go out. The cheating stops with you. That's the principle. That's the whole thing. So we cannot look at what is happening below in terms of what is put out. We must, at a certain point, have our own principle and character. That yes, even if others are doing, I will not do it. And that brings a change in the behavior of people. So that's my report to you, mentioning that in the primary school, parents here to hear that, but before you, it should never happen. That's what you are saying. That is what you want to do. And then you mentioned campus couple. I think you have read that in the sense that one of the missions of the council is to have adequate hostel and catering facilities for our students. When we are touring, I purposely put it, and the council will explain it to them why, that we must visit these private places where our students are living. The council will visit and see it, just like you were describing it. So we will go and see it. So we will convince other members of the council of the need to have this hostel for our students. So we were addressing that very squarely. And it's just a matter of time. We just have about 3 months old. Productivity gone down. Bonus and all the problems. I think this is an issue that we inherited. And we can assure you from the beginning of this. This is where I'm soliciting this. The council is soliciting the help of everybody. When the revenue improves, it helps us do anything we want to do. It is wrong for you to think that because you are a professional with your suit, you can't tell a client, should the VC or the management say, students should not come into the class if they have not paid. You to that and tell the students to go and pay the school for the money. I don't think it reduces students anyway. You are helping the university and yourself to get around. So I think we should take that responsibility and work with the management where there is need to stop people who have not paid fees to come and benefit those who have not paid. So it is, I don't see anything degrading or need a professor to say that to his class. This is what we are pleading for. That everybody to come on board, we're trying to raise our revenue in every way we can. Yeah, I think two people mentioned the creation of new faculties and expansion. Again, we are beginning. Let's put our hands together and let's know where we are. Let's know what we can carry. And then gradually we'll get to the level where we want to be. We can't just do it today. But we have noted all this, and we will have it in mind in whatever we're doing. But the fundamental thing in all of this expansion order is revenue. And you mentioned the issue of the university being a social institution. And that is not so in other places. I'll give you an example. The university, the Michigan State University, is an agricultural university. The people who started it, government gave them land to start the university. And that's how they started it. And they generate their revenue. It's a Union State University, but they generate their revenue. They have a capital branch, they have all the things that are supposed to have, and they generate our money. But more importantly, somebody mentioned it, is discipline in our expenditure. I think we're coming to Professor Lobban mentioned it. I'm coming to that. But it's discipline in our expenditure that makes a difference. Let's not waste the level we have. If we control our expenditure, and do it appropriately, I think we will be conquering this issue of financial autonomy. So while we say financial autonomy, that does not mean we will not go to government for certain things. But at least we should get to a certain level of comfortability that we can say, let's do this. If it's above us, then we'll go to government. So we should not always be crying to government to do this. And if we all put our heads together, look at all the possibilities and exploit them, I think we will achieve what we are talking about. So don't think that because it's a state university, funding must all come from the university, coming from the state. That is not feasible, particularly the thinking. In concurrent legislation, each component revenue has the right to make the law, as long as it is in the concurrent case. It suits their purpose. So that's the way we do. Generally, we are acting as we have a new freedom now. We don't have a new freedom now. And that's how it is, particularly labor. Labor behavior that we have a new government to support them. So that we will do the right thing here. As I mentioned earlier, which is what everybody wants to hear. It's on our mind, and we are doing as we go along. Let me go to what Professor Obama mentioned, which is to make a very, very valid point. And that's the issue of autism. You see, there's a supply and demand issue. And that chain can be broken at one end. Those who are demanding can stop. Those who are supplying can stop. So we are saying that we are aware that some of you here encourage them. That is true, don't deny it. We know it. I'm just being confident that you are a member and you were a former member. So, but I want to say that it is not good for the image of this university. It is not good for the image of this university. And so what they, particularly the life that is lost. When I talk to secondary school students, and I always come there, the day you are signing you can call group, you are signing your death warrant. That is my speech to them, that's how I believe. The day you sign in your form, you are signing your death warrant, you are also signing to be a murderer. So these are issues that we must highlight in our school.
arguments and tell them it does not fail. If a politician offers you some money to come, you should also think, you should get them to be have some integrity in them. They will not accept it for their own sake. Because the politician is doing it for his own sake, that the students should be mature enough, to be stupid enough to say, no, this is against my own life, against my own life. And this is what we want to teach them. And that is trying to deal with the supply. And we know that if we are serious with the industry, many of our students will not be supporting the politicians. Once we're going to have this council, a program that will assist indigenous students, which are the people who are vulnerable. And we have programs to do that. So, Professor Oba, you took the faculty, academic faculty, a major role to stop autism to the university. We have to stop supplying. And he mentioned the issue of cutting down cost. That is so important. It's not just cutting down, but whatever money you have, use it properly to achieve your technical proficiency. There's one thing about me and what we need to go to. All of us need money. Everybody needs. But there is a way you allow yourself to be controlled by the way you seek money, and it distresses you. You know, it becomes your master rather than something to serve you. So let's develop a sense of contentment. A sense of contentment that gives you the happiness, the joy. Some of you have been outside. You saw like professors, lecturers in their small cubicle doing their research. They come in with a rickety car, sit down there. The most important thing that we have to have money to meet the basic needs of the family. Not that we want to ride the car that the person is driving, or that somebody else who has other sources are riding. That's what makes you think you do wrong. Be contented with what you have and what you have. And that will give you true happiness in your life. Not looking at what people have. That's their love. You don't know how they got it. But be contented with what you have and you will resist temptations from mind. There are certain things that you do that is so obvious that people have been, it's clear that you engage the police. But I agree with you that this is allegation, it must be investigation. That's why you have the disciplinary committee, which investigates and then makes the investigation. But as I said, there are certain things that you are caught doing that does not require this because so people will be careful. People will be careful. This time, I tell you, when I was coming back for her being asleep, one of the things that doctors were doing in the hospital is when a patient comes to them, they say, go and see me today. And I talked to them, I said, this is wrong. It's running down the road.